Welcome back again on the lectures related to the nanotechnology. In previous lectures, we have discussed about the nanoscale materials, nanostructured materials, fullerene, nanotubes, and so many compounds, and also their manufacturing processes, how the nanomaterials can be produced in laboratory. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss about the various applications of the nanotechnology and nanostructured materials. The agenda of the lecture is the applications in the field of medicine, in field of electronics, in field of environment, in sport goods, sporting goods, and so many consumer products. So, let us discuss one by one. First is, in the field of medicine, how the nanotechnology is going to be benefited for all human being. This is the factor which is going to serve as a boon in the field of medical technology, advanced medical treatment, that is the size of the material of the nanoscale. So, the size of the nanomaterial is similar to that of most biological molecules and structures. We have seen in some natural nano materials, all the viruses are of the size nanoscale, Ebola virus, HIV virus, so many things. DNA itself is in the range of nanoscale, 2.5 nanoscale. So, since the biological materials are of the nanoscale, so medical technology will be very much enhanced and advanced due to nanotechnology. A benefit of using nanoscale for medical technology is that smaller devices are less invasive and can possibly be implanted inside the body. They are less invasive, means less attacking. They are less injurious for the body. So, that nano devices can easily be implanted inside the body. These devices are faster and more sensitive than typical drug delivery. The efficacy of the drug delivery through nanomedicine is largely based upon the efficient encapsulation of the drugs. The meaning of efficient encapsulation of the drug is the drug to be implanted or injected in the body just at the point where the disease is present. The successful delivery of the drug to the targeted region of the body and successful release of the drug. The drug delivery system, lipid or polymer based nanoparticles, can be designed to improve the biodistribution of the drug, and the drug delivery systems may also be able to prevent tissues damage through the regulated drug release. Since the nanoparticles like nanotube or fullerene, which are having cage structure or hollow structure through which drug can be introduced in various parts of the body inside. Therefore, due to very small size, the tissues will not be damaged inside the body. Gold nanoparticles as probes for the detection of targeted sequence of nucleic acids, and gold nanoparticles are also being clinically investigated as potential treatments for the cancer and other diseases. So, the nanoparticles produced by gold metal can be used as for device for the detection of targeted sequence, and they can also be used in the disease like cancer at the target point. Imaging and diagnostic tools enabled by nanotechnology. The nanoparticles can encapsulate or otherwise help to deliver medication directly to cancer cells and minimize the risk of damage to the healthy tissues. Due to we have discussed in previous lectures, due to formation of power magnets through nanocrystals. The device, the diagnostic devices, can be produced of more precise calculation. So, more precise investigation can be carried out through nano devices. Graphene nano ribbons to help repair spinal cord injuries. So, it is supposed that the nano tubes or graphene can be used for repair of spinal cord injuries on nano scale, and vaccine delivery without the use of needles. Nowadays, for vaccination, we use needles, which is penetrated in the skin, and medicines are injected. But by the use of nanoparticles without injection of any needles, the vaccines can be introduced in the body. The controlled drug delivery system is very important, because in controlled drug delivery system, no excess dose or no less dose is given to the body. Efficient amount of dose is introduced in the body and at the specific target, where the requirement of medicine is there, we can introduce the medicine. That is called as specific drug delivery. Delivering drugs to the specific cell using nanoparticles, lowering in drug consumption and lowering in side effects significantly. So, if no excess drug is introduced in the body, so there is no side effect, and saving of drug material is also very important. So, less consumption of drug will take place. No higher dose needed. Polyethylene glycol, a nanoparticle carrying payload of antibiotics at its core, were used to target bacterial infection more precisely inside the body. So, one compound which is polyethylene glycol is used to use the payload for the bacterial infection in the body. The antibiotic can be introduced in the body very precisely. Another compound, pharmaceutical product, Abraxane. This is used for treatment of breast cancer, which is non-small cell lung cancer and pancreatic cancer. So, in breast cancer, the use of Abraxane is in process. Cancer, the most dangerous disease, the part where the cancer takes place, slowly is decomposes, degraded, multiple cells are formed and function is affected. So, for the treatment of cancer, nanoparticles, how can they play the role? The nanoparticles are useful particularly in imaging, the pointing out the place where the cancer cells are developed. So, by imaging, exact point of cancer disease can be detected through the nano crystals. The nanoparticles such as quantum dots can be used in conjugation with magnetic resonance imaging to produce exceptional images of tumor sites. So, this is these devices which are based on nanotechnology, the quantum dots and magnetic resonance imaging can point out the places, take the images of tumor sites. The carbon nanotubes, 0.5 to 3 nanometer in diameter and 20,000 nanometer in length, are used for detection of DNA mutation and for detection of disease protein biomarker. So, the cancer disease takes place due to DNA mutation. So, DNA mutation can easily be detected with nanotechnology based devices. Dendrimers, it is less than 10 nanometer in size, are very much useful for controlled release of drug and image contrast agents. Dendrimers are the compounds which are like tree, there are so many branches. So, through these branches drug delivery can be introduced, the drug can be transported in the inside the body. This is a structure for the dendrimers. So many branches are there and it is a nanomaterial. So, dendrimers are repetitively branched molecules. The name comes from the Greek word dendron, which translates to tree, which is branched material, dendrimers. The very important example of a dendrimer is, this is the biggest molecule ever synthesized in a laboratory, which is known as PG5. It is type of dendrimer, so many branches are there, and you will be surprised, in this compound 15 million carbons and about 40 million hydrogens are present, and its molecular weight is 200 million. So, big compound which has been synthesized in the laboratory, which can be used as a nano compound for drug delivery system as dendrimers. You can make this molecule after 170,000 reaction sequences. So, this compound is prepared in laboratory by various sequences, this is in number 170,000 sequences. So, big compound and so high molecular weight compound. So, nanocrystals of 2 to 9.5 nanometer size cause improved formulation for poorly soluble drugs. Labeling of breast cancer marker HER2, surface of cancer cells. So, these are some compounds which can be used, these are nano compounds which are used in medicine, in medical treatment. The nanoparticles are of 10 to 1000 nanometer size and are used in MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, and ultrasounds image, contrast agents, and for targeted drug delivery as permeation enhancers and as reporters of the apoptosis, angiogenesis. Some nano shells are developed which find applications in tumor specific imaging, deep tissues, and thermal ablation. So, these are some nanoparticles which have been developed for treatment in various diseases. Now, come to the applications of nanocrystals and nanoparticles and nano devices in electronics. The electronics solely based on the semiconductors. So, semiconductors, some of the most revolutionary applications in nanotechnology are the semiconductor areas, computers. Nobody expected when first computer was built, it was around the size of this room, a very huge, a very big room size. Now, computer size has been decreased that we can keep in our pocket in form of mobile phones. The size of chip is so decreased and very small chip, we can store a lot of data. So, decreasing the size played a very crucial and important role in development of various electronic devices and instruments. There are now microprocessors of so high speed that 100 nanometers in size, and they smaller the processor, the faster is the processing time and more power can be put into the computer. So, as the size of the processor is decreased, the efficiency and speed of the computer is increased. So, improved computer screens using carbon nanotubes with so digital and high definition screens are developed, in which very much improved color and contrast are developed. Similarly, memory, the memory of computer, which is based on chips, the nanotechnology can solve many of the current problems with memory storage. We need so many types of data for storage, and if in a small chip we can store so much data, that will be very much benefited for all development. Then it is nano dots. A possible new form of data storage is using nano sized bits of nickel called nano dots. They could be used to store terabytes of data and be used in homes and workshops. So, nano dots are so small, but they can store a lot of data in their memory. Using magnetic random access memory, MRAM, computers will be able to boot almost instantly. Nowadays, it takes 5 minutes, 10 minutes, sometimes 15, 20 minutes, but by the use of magnetic random access memories, the smaller processors, the booting time of computer will be decreased. It may be boot in seconds only. Ultra high definition displays and televisions are now being sold that use quantum dots to produce more vibrant colors while being more energy efficient. So, the quantum dots are being used in various display devices, so that we get very good color, very good contrast and bright features on the screen. These are the figure of quantum dots. So, there are some more advantages of nanotechnology: reducing power consumption as the device, the size of the device is decreased, there is more efficiency, then the power consumption is reduced. Second is improving display screens on electronic devices, reducing the size of transistor used in integrated circuits. By reducing the size of transistors, the device size can also be decreased. Nano lithography is used for fabrication of chips. So, lithography is a process of printing. So, by nano lithography, we can form, we can manufacture the chips of very small size. So, nano lithography is used for fabrication of small nano sized chips. Decreasing the weight and thickness of the screens. By decreasing the weight and thickness of the screen, the devices can be made more compact and usable and portable, and increasing the density of memory chips also. So, the density of memory chips can also be reduced. Graphene transistor is one of the example of nano technology which is used in electronics. Graphene is single sheet of carbon, we have discussed in previous lectures, of thickness of about 0.335 nanometer. Its structure is just like honeycomb, hexagonal carbon rings are there, and only one single sheet of graphite is called as graphene. The isolated from graphite allows electrons to move at an extraordinary high speed, so that electrical conductivity is increased. With its intrinsic nature of being one atom thick fabricated field effect transistors that are faster and smaller. So, by using the graphene, the faster transistor can be produced. Here are some examples on which graphene is coated. This is silicon metal used as semiconductor on which a coating of silicon oxide is, and there is a very thin one film of graphene is coated, which is a conducting band. Another nano wire is produced by graphene. Single electron transistor is another application of nanocrystals and nano materials in electronics. A single electron transistor needs only one electron to change from the insulating to the conducting state. Only one electron is required. So, if only one electron is required, so the speed and accuracy and efficiency will enhance dramatically, deliver very high device density and power efficiency with a remarkable operational speed. The quantum dots with sub 100 nanometer dimensions have to be fabricated. So, by using single electron transistor, the efficiency of all the electronic devices can be enhanced by very high speed. The carbon based nano sensors like graphene and carbon nanotubes have been developed for various uses. So, these graphene and carbon nanotubes have already been developed and they are used in as nano sensors. Displays carbon nanotubes on a glass or plastic sheet allow manufacturers to make clear conductive panels for displays that are extremely thin. This is also an example of nanotechnology. Here we are using the screen on which the conductivity is so high, we can carve any design through this pen. So, this display board is also an example of nanotechnology. For flexible electronics, graphene is nothing but an allotrope of carbon that has superb electrical conductivity. We know it is, and it is very flexible and very physically very strong. The strength of graphene is very high. The strength and flexibility both, it increases with decrease in size. So, graphene is a very small component nanocrystal, therefore, it is very strong. Wearing single walled carbon nanotubes electronics on your skin, a temporary tattoo to monitor glucose level, or graphene nanosensors tattoo on teeth monitors bacteria in your mouth. So, there are some devices are being prepared through graphene that can be put on the skin, just skin, and they will device will sense the blood glucose, and that will sense the bacteria present in our teeth. So, such type of devices can be prepared by graphene. The computer technologies, mobile phones, digital cameras and other high technology equipments, these are all based on nanotechnology. Moore's law, decrease in size and increase in density. This is decrease in size and increase in density. Faster and smaller non-silicon based chip sets, these are memory and processors. So, non-silicon based chips are being prepared of nano size. New materials for semiconductors that increase the processing speed. So, by the use of nanocrystals, some new semiconductors are being produced, which can increase the speed of microprocessors and other chemical processings. Advanced microscopy, faster and smaller telecom switches, higher speed transmissions, new class of displays using carbon nanotubes, emission devices and flat screen TVs and computer monitors, which we are using in our daily life. So there are so many advantages in applications of nano structured materials in the field of electronics. Optoelectronics, another field which is based on optics and electronics. So, the optoelectronic devices can be prepared in the modern communication technology. Traditional analog electrical devices are increasingly replaced by optical or optoelectronic devices due to their enormous bandwidth and capacity. So, some optoelectronic devices are being produced. Two promising examples are, one is photonic crystal and quantum dots. We have already discussed. The production of displays with low energy consumption might be accomplished using carbon nanotubes or silicon nano wires. So, some devices can be produced by using carbon nanotubes and carbon nano wires of more, they will be more efficient and power consumption will also be very less. Now, come to the applications of nanotechnology in environmental issues. They are in this developing age when the so many types of devices are produced, various types of pollutions are created in environment, vehicular pollution, air pollution, water pollution, some more chemical pollution, thermal pollution. So, these how can the nanotechnology be useful in controlling the environmental pollution? Here is some important points. The silver nano clusters, which can be used for treatment of water pollution, less pollution during the manufacture of materials. The silver nanocrystal can absorb so many types of polluting elements present in the environment. The manufacture propylene dioxide, some pollutants are generated in process that can be captured by silver nanocrystals. Propylene oxide is used to produce common materials such as plastics, paints, detergents and brake fluids. So, by using propylene oxide, some various types of pollutants are created in the environment, and by using silver nanocrystal as the catalyst, significantly reduce the polluting byproducts. So, byproducts formed can be catalyzed by silver nanocrystals to reduce the pollution. Producing solar cells that generate electricity at low cost. Silicon nanowires, which are more efficient, therefore, such silicon nanowires array can be used in solar cells that will reduce the cost of the solar cell. Epoxy containing carbon nanotubes is being used to make windmill blades. The resulting blades are stronger and low weight, and therefore, the amount of electricity generated by each windmill is greater. These type of windmills, generally windmills blades were made of metals, but by making some epoxy containing carbon nanotubes, the weight of the windmill blade is reduced and efficiency is reduced. They are corrosion free, so efficiency is increased and more electricity can be generated. Thin film membrane with nanopores for energy efficient desalination. There is a major problem where fresh water is not available. So, fresh water is produced by desalination of sea water. There are so many processes for water treatment. One is the production of nanopore membrane. Through membranes, desalination, the salt dissolved in the water is removed, so that fresh water or pure water can be created. The nano fabric paper towel, today we know that some fabricated paper towels are available, which is known as antibacterial. such type of paper towel can be produced from tiny vats of the potassium manganese oxide that can absorb 20 times its weight in oil for cleanup applications. So, that paper can absorb more oil which is made by potassium manganese oxide nano tiny wires. Nanotechnology enabled sensors and solutions are now able to detect and identify chemical or biological agents in the air, soil with much higher sensitivity than ever before. So, the polluting material present in metal, in air or in water can be detected by the use of sensors, nano sensors. Iron nanoparticles can be effective in cleaning up organic solvents that are polluting groundwater. The iron nanoparticles disperse throughout the body of water and decompose the organic solvent in the place. So, in water, if some organic pollutants are present, iron nanoparticles can easily decompose that pollutant and clean up the water. Using photocatalytic copper tungsten oxide nanoparticles to break down oil into biodegradable compounds, the nanoparticles are in grid that provides high surface area for the reaction, is activated by sunlight and can work in water, making them useful for cleaning up oil spills. So, these photocatalytic copper tungsten oxide nanoparticles can be used for removal of pollutants from water. Cleaning volatile organic compounds from the air, the catalyst which is composed of porous manganese oxide in which gold nanoparticles have been embedded can decompose organic compound also. So, some type of nano compounds developed which are nanoparticles in which gold nanoparticles are present, they can decompose organic compounds. Reducing the cost of fuel cell, changing the spacing of platinum atoms and used in a fuel cell increases the catalytic ability of the platinum. So, by catalytic ability of platinum, increasing the catalytic ability of platinum, fuel cell cost can be reduced. And storing hydrogen for fuel cell powered cars using graphene layers to increase the binding energy of hydrogen, the graphene, the fuel cell can store more hydrogen through graphene cells. Now, come to the use of nanotechnology and nano materials in sports. Wilson, a company, has been able to create tennis rackets that are twice as stable conventional racket and up to 22% more powerful. Basically, what we they done, they introduced some carbon nanotubes in the material of racket that created a very much more strength in the racket, increasing the strength of tennis rackets by adding nanotubes to the frames, which increases control and power when you hit the ball, reducing the rate at which air leaks from the tennis balls. So, they keep their bounce longer. Filling any imperfection in club shaft material with nanoparticles, this improves the uniformity of the material that make up the shaft and thereby improving your swings. So, some nanoparticles are introduced in various sporting materials, sporting devices, so that its efficiency is increased. The lightweight swimwear are produced so that the swimmer experiences no weight, they glide in the water. So, very lightweight swimwear are produced through nano fabrics. There are some more important applications of nanocomposite materials and nanocrystals. Nanocomposite barrier film that prevents air loss from tennis ball. Tennis racket frame containing silicon dioxide nanoparticles increases the strength, stability and power. Epoxy containing carbon nanotubes coating the skin of kayaks. Kayaks are a type of boat that increases abrasion resistance. Resin containing buckyballs, which is also called as fullerene, used to make badminton rackets that increases power and stability of the racket. Bicycle parts made with the carbon nanotubes that increases stiffness without weight increase. Ski wax made with the nanocomposites increasing gliding performance and maximum speed. Fishing rods made with the epoxy resins made with silica nanoparticles that increase the strength without weight increase. So many nanoparticles when introduced in sporting devices, their strength, weight all modified according to the need. Now, there are some more and major advantages and applications in daily consumer products of nanotechnology. Nanoporous materials called aerogel, that is an excellent insulator, for example, knapsacks and briefcases that include flexible nanoparticles based on solar cells to charge your cell phone and other devices on go. So, these are very good insulators, they are used in various devices. Skin care products that are nanoparticles to deliver vitamins deeper into the skin. In daily life, so many creams, sunscreens are used as cosmetics. The sunscreens that use nanoparticles to block UV rays without leaving white residue on the skin. So, sunscreens are used on the skin so that the UV rays coming from the sunlight cannot penetrate into the skin. We know that UV light is very much injurious for our body. There are so many physiological changes takes place and skin diseases also. Lithium ion batteries that are nanoparticle based, they are used in plug-in electric cars. Flame retardant formed by the coating, the foam used in furniture with carbon nanofibers. So, many carbon nanofibers here have been developed, which are used as insulators, flame retardant, they will not catch fire. Fishing rods that use silica nanoparticles to fill the space between, and carbon fibers is strengthening the rod without increase in the weight. So, very important factor is how to increase the strength, how to increase the stiffness, how to increase the service life, but weight should be lowered. Without increasing weight, if we produce some strength, some stiffness, some enhanced service life, that is the role of nanotechnology in our daily life. With these words, I conclude. We have discussed the use of nanotechnology in treatment of cancer, in controlled drug delivery system, in medical equipments of more precise determination, in electronics, so many nano sensors are developed, nano radios, computer and mobile devices have been developed of more efficient devices. Environment, energy efficient desalination, nano solar cells, nano fabrics, these have been developed to control the pollution. Sporting goods, more precise tennis balls, rackets, fishing rods, bicycle parts, etcetera, have been developed, and so many consumer products like sunscreen, lotions, batteries, nano fabrics have been developed, and so many products are in process that will change the whole life of human being and of this earth in near future. Thank you so much.